My throat. My butt. My butt! Oh, I guess I'm doing a recording now, so I should turn off nostalgic tunes. What's up, girl? I should... Oh, you know what? No, it's not important yet. I can't even buy money yet. The only reason I would do that is for money. Thank you. Thanks very much, cutie. That's my fucking line. Christ. Oh, no, he's dead.
Francesca. Oh, poor boss. The big man's been sick with loneliness ever since his daughter skedaddled. I run the bus, Frankie is gone. The boss is in shambles. What's a syndicate to do? That scruffy gang of punk thieves is stealing jobs from us right and left. But enough about us and our stupid problems, huh? What can we do for yous?
What?
Tickets for the Red Seer's train around, for the XS Express.
Whoa, you want tickets for that, Roland Wing Ding?
Ooh, ain't nothing we can do about that.
Yeah, us giving out tickets? That's rich. You gotta talk to the boss for that.
Francesca.
I just can't stand seeing the boss like this. If only we could help the boss see his daughter again.
You mean that cutie Frankie and that darling Francesca? They were on Keelhaul Key.
Who's on the what now? What did you just say? Repeat that. You know where the young miss... You know where the young Miss Piata's at?
Really?
No lie! I swear to you, if you're lying, I will turn you into confetti, so help me! Well, if that's where she is, why don't you bring her back here, huh? Be a pal! We'd go ourselves, but we can't leave the boss unprotected, you get me? Yeah, you bring us young Miss Francesca, and we'll ask the boss to do something about your little train ticket situation. You got a deal or what?
Deal.
See? Now that's better. I knew you once you understood our predicament, you couldn't refuse. Don't screw this up!
Only I don't have any shine sprites, do I? No, I don't think it's possible for me to get any more before chapter 6. But once we have the ones from chapter 6, how many do we need left to alter rank? We need like 12 more, don't we? There's two in Far Outpost. Yeah, 3, 6, 9, 12. Jeez, are there really that many left? I know there's 3 in the sewers and they're out there and they're all in one room together. There might be two in Poshley Heights. There's a couple in Riverside Station too. Oh, right, we gotta go to. This will be quick. This will be very quick with the convenient fast travel pipe. Because the fast travel pipe to Keelhaul Key in the original game didn't open up until after you got back from chapter six because you needed to get the Ultra Hammer, which is in that chest up there. But you can't get it without the ultra boots that you get in chapter 6. So, yeah. Anyway, go ahead. Thank you.
Stupid, stinky, stoop.
Man, her back is so fat. Yeah, hit my fat back. Oh yeah, there's no enemies here because we got the, I'm gonna have to walk all the way across this damn... Jeez, I forgot to make you do this again! Hey, guys.
Oh, hey, it's Mario. How you been there, pal? Me do something for you?
Uh-huh.
What? The boss is sick!
Oh, poor daddy. Oh, no, and at a time like this! You see, I just dropped the wedding ring Frankie gave me around here. I can't possibly leave until I find that ring, otherwise something may eat it. Must be somewhere between here and that skull rock.
Listen for a second, my fuzzy little coconut. Shouldn't we forget about that ring for now and check on the boss?
How could you say that, Frankie? That ring was the symbol of our love. We have to find it. We have to. Or maybe you just don't love me anymore. Is that it?
Of course I love you, my little bacon burger.
None of your sweet talk now. You're gonna say you love me 100 times.
100 times?
If you love me, you have to say it, Frankie.
Oh, come on now, babe. Of course I love you, my little short stack. Now, please, let's go.
No, you have to say it 99 more times, Frankie.
Aw, fine, you dizzy dame. I love you. I love you. Oh my god, they made it even slower. I love you. 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 There, I said it.
Oh, Frankie, baby, you're such silly Billy.
You don't need to capitalize that.
Now, my little cream puff, let's find that ring right away. What do you say?
Do you think these two can really make it on their own, dearie? Personally, I don't think so. Yes, we should help them.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I need to go back and rewatch Aaron and Dan's reaction to that.
I love you. I love you.
Oh my god. Man, you think I always talk about how Super Paper Mario is the game in the series that has the balls to waste your fucking time. Man, I wish they would let you do that, you know? Like, I just want to get a fucking coconut without it needing to be a federal fucking issue, all right? I'm sorry. I'm sorry, okay? Douche. Yes. I'll take two. You know, I think I'll have a breast today. And the next piece I want a breast. 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 Yay. Hey guys. Oh boy. There you go.
Ah! That's it! That's my ring! You found it! Frankie, now we can go home to Daddy.
You sure can, my little cheese and cracker. Let's go!
Well, so anyway, we'll be down at the dock. Hurry back, please.
I wonder if we have to ride the boat back with them. Because in the original, it wasn't even possible to unlock the fast travel point unless you did a glitchy sequence break. In the original, you had to wait until after chapter 6 to unlock the fast travel point. So you had to take the boat here and back.
That's interesting to think about. I'm going to get an ice storm.
Whatever.
Okay, Mario, I think we're ready, pal. Yeah, we are. Let's go back to Rogueport.
Oh, Daddy, please hang on until we get there.
Hey, Cortez. He turns. What are you doing?
¿Qué pasa? Need to go back to Rogueport? Que pasa? ¿Quieres más? Muy bien, you're off. Perfecto.
My god! Could you possibly get any closer to the screen? Okay, yeah, okay. It's a boat. Okay, I get it.
We have to go see Daddy immediately!
You got it, Francesca! Let's go! Oi, 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 oi.
One of the finest I've seen! After this adventure, we're going on tour to appear on stages everywhere! I'm going to be known as the Red Miracle, and of course, Luigi will be grass.
That is the smuggest Daisy I've ever seen in my life. Oh my god. The grass thing? I could never play grass. I'd want to play a princess, and a prince would wake me with a kiss. So romantic. Really? Okay. Man, I just noticed, like, how fucking rickety and raggedy this, like, board job is here. Like, look at this. Like, this, like, platform here is seriously fucked up, and these, like, squeaky planks are the only thing preserving the walk up to this door that goes into town. Like, man, that's fucked up. Yes, please. Little known fact, if you put the Slogo badge on while playing the original, you start playing the remake. Wait a second. Oh, no, that's the thing that goes to the games. I remember. Yeah, look at this. I came in here. The most expensive stuff in here is 600 fucking piantas now. Oh my god. I'm pretty sure the prices never went above 234 in the original game. Maybe 300. But, like, I shudder to see how expensive money is. At least, they added something. You can actually trade. They added one more level of efficiency to the Pianta Changer. You can exchange 150 coins for 50 piantas. Whereas in the original game, the fastest exchange was 10 for 30 coins. Hey guys.
Daddy, 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 wake up! Open your eyes!
Boss, you gotta open your eyes, Pelly! Ever since you left for the island, the boss's condition just kept getting worse. Oh no. This is just awful. And after the two of yous came all the way back too. Francesca? Oh!
Daddy!
Boss! Oh, my little Francesca, you came back for me, and you do, Frankie.
Of course we did, Daddy! As soon as we heard you were ill, we dropped everything and rushed back.
Francesca, Frankie, I was wrong. I was a stubborn old man. Forgive me. I know I may regret saying this, but I want the two of you to stay here with me. I can't bear to be away from you two lovebirds. I'm an old man now. I need peace. Jump. I guess the time has come for me to stop being so selfish, causing everyone trouble. Looks like even Don Pianta, the Don of Untimely Death, can't escape the old age. The time has come, everyone! I'm gonna retire. Whoa, boss! No, it's time. I mean it. And I want you to be my successor, Frankie! What do you say, Frankie? As of today, you are the new head of the Pianta Syndicate! What? But boss, you still got it in you! You're a spring chicken! You don't gotta do this! And I mean, me? Boss?
No, you're the one, Frankie. I've been thinking that for a long time now. You'll do just fine, kid. I got a feeling about you. A good one. I want you to take care of Francesca and the rest of the syndicate, the way I did. Boss! You, Mario. It looks like you've done yet another favor for me, kid.
Yeah.
About that, boss. Oh, this is gonna be just beautiful. I know it. What did you guys do?
Well, we kinda promised them something, boss. We told them we would ask you about a ticket for the SX Express if we brought your daughter.
Whoa, is that all? You had me worried for a second. Come on over here, Mario. How many you want? 1, 2, 10? Help yourself.
So happy.
Yay!
You come back anytime you like. How about that?
Whoa.
Okay. Well, now that I've retired, I'm gonna get out of here.
Daddy!
Boss!
You're the boss now, Frankie. You got that? You, the boss. You do good now, Frankie. Gonna go, whatever.
Okay. Well, there you go.
You've got lots of work to do, and don't worry, I'll keep you in line.
Sweet Bean, come on!
Knock it off with the pet name nonsense, will you?
What the hell? Oh, never mind. Never mind with that fucking voice. Soon I won't have to ever voice her ever again.
Huh? Francesca?
Or Miss Boss, tee-hee!
I'm the boss. I mean, boss, you got our loyalty. We'll be by your side whenever you need us, boss.
Thank you so much, Mario, for everything.
You're welcome here anytime. You're like a brother to me. You ain't bad, kiddo.
Stop talking, guys! Jesus!
It's the life, kid!
Funk.
I've got my arms in the air. I'm doing the monkey arms. I'm doing the monkey arms. I got my arms in the air. I'm doing the monkey arms.
So dumb. Funk.
Lovely. Next stop, Partially Heights. Marvelous. I've begun to think we should find that next crystal star as fast as we can.
I heard that, my uglies. So the sixth crystal star is in Partially Heights, is it? That's a rather nice piece of information. Thanks ever so.
Oh my god! Oh my, you're Beldum! How do you know? You don't know that! You ain't even met the bitch!
Normally, this would be where I finally deal with you and that sappy traitor Vivian. But something tells me that trying that alone might be unwise. So you live for now. Instead, I'll just beat you to Partially Heights and get that crystal star before you do!
We better move, Mario, if she gets to Partially Heights before we do. Quickly, to Rogueport Station!
Actually, I have a couple of last-minute boss time errands to run. Excuse me. Excuse me, lamppost! I'm trying to walk here! Thank you!
Why can't I throw the boomerang? Thank you!
I wanna make a zest frappe, I believe is what I'm gonna smash it back. You're looking well or whatever. With a cake mix. Oh, I can make a cocoa pop too.
Shit!
Okay, well, I'll make a cocoa pop.
Dump and chunk.
Oh, cocoa candy. Okay. Oh shoot, you know what? Hang on. Okay, I want to get a fire. I want to get two fire flowers, and I want to go. I want to quickly hop over to the Boggly Tree to grab a mystic egg, and I also need to stop by Pianta Parlor for one more cake mix. Hey, Petunie.
Aw, Petunie was always getting in trouble with the Elder. It's no fun for me. Hey, hey, Mario, can't you play with me instead?
Sure, kid.
Yes! Okay, okay, this is so awesome. Ready to play Stump Petunie? Ask me any questions you want. There isn't a question I can't answer. Come on!
Create an easy question that Petunie can answer. Mario... likes... which person... the most?
Teehee, I know that. You can't stump Petunie. Mario likes Princess Peach the most. Am I right?
Mm-hmm. You know what would have been funny here would be if they added more questions that she had an answer to, even if it made absolutely no sense. There you go. An egg. I wonder if they made this easier. Did they make this more convenient? No, they did not. Okay. Maybe they made it slightly more convenient. I'm gonna try going in and out of the room, because I think before you had to leave the whole area to get her to play again. But I don't know if you can just leave the room and maybe she'll reset. That would sure be nice if they changed that.
Ah, they didn't.
How annoying. Yeah, because you need eggs for, like, a not insignificant amount of recipes. What we're gonna make is something very exciting. We're gonna make a bomb. We're going to get Zesty to make us a bomb. Oh, these aren't homemade. They were made in a video game. A Mario video game. They're toasters.
Oh, well, that's too bad. I thought they were bombs.
Wait! We were just kidding about all that Mario stuff. So what flavor is it? What flavor is it? I'm surprised they didn't add anything to do with the right stick in this game at all. Sup, Don Pianta. Isn't it fucked that the only place you can get a cake mix in this entire town is from the casino? Like, just think about that, you know? Like, imagine if you had to go to the casino to get, like, flour, you know? I mean, that would be ridiculous. Yeah, Mystic Egg and Fire Flower makes an egg bomb.
This is what came out. Whoa.
Jeez. Coconut and Fire Flower. Okay, I want to show you how many times I can push the A button in between selecting the second ingredient and hitting OK. I want to show you how many times I can push the A button between those two things. Those two inputs that are directly concurrent. Okay, cake mix? Listen to this. I'm gonna mash the A button. We're going to count. How many was that? Like 10? 10 times? Like, oh my god! What? Oh, shit. Oh. Huh, I thought that was how you made a Zest Frappe. Wait, really? What, wait, hang on, what did I just, did I just mix what I meant to? Yeah, you know what? I think it's a maple syrup and a, yeah, okay. It's a maple syrup and an ice storm. Okay, hold on. We can go to Keel Hall Key and quickly grab another ice storm. Ingredients. Ice storm. Oh, ice storm and a honey syrup makes an icicle pop. Do I have another golden leaf?
I don't think I do. But if I do, then I could totally make...
You can make a snow cone?
That just looks like a zest frappe. That's in Super. That's in Super Paper Mario. Do I have another gold leaf in storage, perchance? Withdraw. No, I do not. I could get one pretty quick, though. Okay, let's buy 3 ice storms. Oh, you know what? I'm going to get a free mushroom. What a pain. I don't care! Oh my god. Thanks for interrupting my... Well, actually, no, you're not interrupting my purchasing. And we need a honey syrup. I give you this mushy. Now we're gonna quickly hop over to Creepy Steeple, which is quick in this version because of these fast travel pipes. Because they added that pipe that goes right into the Creepy Steeple basement. Which is still a little bit of a walk away from the from where you get the golden thing. You know, honestly, it makes me wonder if it might have just been a good idea to just, you know, do the fast travel pipes like they did in Superstar Saga. Like, basically just have a bunch of fast travel points that are all linked together. You don't have, like, just have fast travel points that aren't unique and, like, you know, linked up in pairs. Just have, like, a bunch of different pipes that all connect to each other that you can just pick which one you want to go to. You could even use the map, you know? I mean, heck, they have this map here. Is this... Can I really not zoom in? I'm only missing one star piece in Rogueport. Huh. Is that so? Or maybe like two. I wonder where that is. I don't think there are any star pieces in Rogueport that require this... In, like, Rogueport above ground that require the spring jump. Or the Ultra Hammer. Well, there also aren't that many places to look. Man, the Garnet Star looks crazy. It's like such a bright orange. Yeah, everything over there is complete. Anyway, what am I doing? Yeah, I can make 3 things with the ice storm, and they're all relatively accessible because of these fast travel pipes. Man, if only there was a... Man, how nice would it be if you could get the return pipe from Super in this game now? That would be so convenient. I mean, in Super Paper Mario, it was a little more important to be able to do that. Because, you know... Now, here's the problem. Okay, you know what I should do? Since I have so many items that refill FP... Like, this... I should do a setup that incentivizes me to loot... To like, use as much FP as possible... Which means I should set, like, basically every single ability I have that uses FP. You know? Ice Smash, Head Rattle, Hammer Throw, Power Smash, Soft Stomp, Sleepy Stomp, Shrink Stomp, Multi Bounce. Just set them all, you know? That's actually, like, a really fun way to play, too. Double Dip. You know what? Let's take off Double Dip. And we'll take off... Anything here I would be comfortable getting rid of? No, not really.
Well, let's go for a power plus P. And spike shield is going to be important. Well, actually, you know what? No. I'm thinking about those spiky parabuzzies. Because even hammer throw wouldn't do me any good against those guys because it won't do enough damage to actually pierce their defense. And even if it did do enough damage, I'm not sure if it would actually knock them down. How about Zap? How about Zap Tap? And we'll put on a... Sure, let's put on Unsimple. Actually, no, I want to put on Refund. Dude, get out of the fucking way. At least I can actually hit these guys because I have Quake Hammer! Or Hammer Throw. Sure, I've never used this before. I haven't used this in this... Oh, that's weird. They changed the look of... Why does Hammer Throw do piss for damage? What the hell? That's supposed to do normal hammer damage. Oh, man. What are you doing? Come on, man. What are you doing? Yeah, I need to do... I need a setup that encourages me to use as much FP as possible. Well, I don't know if this even necessarily does that, really, because most of the stuff is stuff that I'm just never going to use anyway. I mean, if you really want to use a lot of FP quickly, well, all you need is to incentivize yourself to spam Fiery Jinx all the time. Yeah. Just take all this junk off. Multi-bounce is staying on. You know what would be nice? Oh, you know what would be so nice? Oh my god, could you imagine a skill or a badge in this game that was like a magic booster in Final Fantasy X? That like, it increases the ability, it increases the power of any skill that uses FP, but it increases the amount of FP that it costs, you know? Like, increases the power of a move by 2 points, but it costs twice as much FP to use it. That would be so cool. That would work like, that would genuinely work like so well. Yeah, that'll do. I don't need to go crazy here. What do you want, Discord? Dick sword. It's one of those modding servers that I'm in. Dude, really? Were you watching me up there? Just ready to pounce happily? Oh, nice. Right, she's ultra rank now. So she can actually one-shot those fools. Man, are we ever gonna get to chapter 6 here? Good Jesus Christ. Oh, man, I just had a thought. You know what would actually be pretty fun? Would be if there was like another zero BP cosmetic badge that actually like reskinned all the enemies that got like homogenized designs in like Sticker Star. Like you got like Booze and Dry Bones and Hammer Bros and all that stuff. Because a lot of enemies and maybe even like Koopas looking like turning into like green Koopas. Because a lot of, you know, enemies... that had sort of unique, stylized designs in Paper Mario. In Paper Mario 1, 2, and 3, when Sticker Star came around, they got, like... they got, reskinned to look more like... to look more in line with the characters in the main series Mario games. And I'm glad that they have the originals here, but I am curious to see how it would look if you had the option to, you know... to play the other way. Okay, so we're in Honey Syrup and one of our three Ice Storms. This will make an icicle pop. Doodle dee doo da. Luck, 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 luck. And we can mix a maple syrup with an ice storm, and this makes what I thought I was going to make before with the cake mix. Because there are so many times you, like, mix a cake mix with something and it makes a candy for some reason. But no, for the ice storms you need syrups, which makes sense. Like, you know, you mix a coconut with a cake mix and you get, like, a wrapped hard candy. So I don't think that mixing an ice storm and a... cake mix and expecting to get, you know, a snow cone, expecting to get shaved ice out of it is that ridiculous, you know, is that out of line. Okay, now an ice storm and a golden leaf make something very interesting. And that makes a snow bunny. Now, I believe... hang on a second. Don't you make this into, is that not... okay, is this not what you combine with that? What? Dude, piss off! I know that this is a recipe in this game. How do you make that? Yeah, that's what I thought! Why is that not on either the Snow Bunny or the Spicy Soup page? That's whack, dude. We also want to mix together the coconut bomb and the egg bomb. Roll dee doo da. Luck, 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 luck. Oh, interesting. I wonder if the animation there at the middle, at like the man, I have a knife rack that looks exactly like that. There we go, Zest Dynamite.
You said you need black powder, yes? 38 gold pieces for the barrel.
How do you make a poison mushroom? No, in the fucking Paper Mario games, you jackass. Inky sauce, slow shroom. Oh, that's a pain in the ass. Point swap is easy to get, at least. Slow shrooms are easy to get, too. Okay, hang on. We're gonna make some weird shit. I'm gonna do a whole bunch of cooking right now. I guess we're just not doing Chapter 6. We're just gonna do a whole bunch of cooking. I'm gonna do a whole bunch of cooking that simultaneously clears my inventory out of all this junk I don't need. I'm sorry, Vivian. I hammered you. We're also going to dip into the underground. Okay, I guess we're getting the point swap first. Because this is not the quickest way to get to that area. Dude! Oh my god, how many times am I gonna do that? Whiff the jump and then read the fucking sign? Like, I know, it goes to Glitzville, okay? I'm not stupid! Urg. Okay, that point swap that's colored differently for some reason. Mm-hmm. All right. Now we're going to hop up here. Run over to the west side. Well, actually, it would be easier to go this way. Easier, like it would actually be difficult either way or something. But it's impossible for me to mess up platforming going this way. How many star pieces do I have? 4. Yeah. Not gonna be able to buy much more from Dazzle. Well, Dazzle doesn't have that much more to buy. Yeah, just 15 coins for this. Yes, okay! Oh my god! Thank you! Why are you doing business down here? Are you doing business explicitly so that, you know, people who live down here, who have to live down here, have, like, food? Because that would actually be pretty nice. I wonder if that's, like, part of the idea. Like, oh, man, that gives me an idea. Like, what if slow shrooms are, like... What if slow shrooms, right, were, like, specifically cultivated to be, like, long-term rations, you know? Like, the purpose of a slow shroom is that it keeps you, like, fed for, like, a very long time. Because it takes a really long time to digest or something. Okay, first let's see if it's over here. Because that stupid ultra hammer chest is gonna give us a false positive until we get home from chapter 6. No, nothing in here. No? Okay, it must be in the central town. That's annoying, because that means we can't use Miss Malice to probe for it, because she's gonna keep picking up that stupid ultra hammer chest. But I think I know where it is, because there aren't any other plates. Like, it could be on the docks, but I'm pretty sure I have everything in the docks already. There is a star piece panel over here, right? Yeah. Oh, okay, I didn't have that one. Cool. That should be everything in Rogueport. We haven't unlocked. Unfortunately, Rogueport sewers counts as Rogueport, so we still don't unlock anything in the sound gallery. But we'll be able to once we come back from Chapter 6, because once we come back from Chapter 6, we'll have every movement ability. We'll have every, like, navigational, every field ability in the game. So we don't have to worry about that ever again. Not being able to get anywhere. We need to get more gold leaves, because isn't that how you make shroom broth? Or can you do that with a turtley leaf? I don't think you can do that with a turtley leaf. Slow mushrooms are like weirdly picky when it comes to making, like, recipes. I don't know why. There's our poison mushroom. Eat it and it'll poison you! Yay! And we'll also cook one item, which is the fire flower. Man, I wish that refund would apply when you give items to Zesty to cook them, like, for, like, loss. But, I mean, that's the kind of thing, is you're already getting something in return for it, but... Okay, now we make the spicy soup. We mix the spicy soup and the snow bunny. Does it actually refill 15 HP? I thought it refilled FP. Huh? Ah. Snow bunny! Spicy Snoop and Snow Bunny makes a couple's cake. You can share it. I wonder if you actually can in this one, because in the original, it was really, really, really stupidly useless. Literally, all you could do with this, how this item worked in the original was that you could only use it on the other character. Like, one character had to use it on the other character, and it would just give them 10 turns of HP regen. So it was basically just a worse version of a slow shroom. Now, if we combine that with a poison mushroom... we get Trial Stew. Amazing food made by Zesty. Yields it looks like a bowl full of, like, gummy bears. I don't think I have anything else I need to make. I could get rid of some of these fucking courage shells, but I can't cook them into anything. Well, I could. I could cook one of them into a courage meal. Yeah, you know what? Let me do that. Yeah, because I'm probably never gonna find the perfect time to use this zest special. So let's just combine it with a courage shell, and get a courage meal that does 4 damage to something, so that I can at least use that. That could genuinely, literally be useful in Chapter 5. It's funny how terrible the sprite for the courage meal looks. I find myself comparing, like, all these, like, new item textures to what I remember making for my LP. Because when I did my LP, I got, like, the Dolphin HD texture pack. But it was missing a lot of items and recipes, especially. So I would actually, like, go through and, like, plan what recipes I was gonna make and make textures, like, literally... make my own remastered high-res textures in GIMP for the items. And, like, I thought they turned out pretty good, but the thing was that I was very much basing my artwork on, like, basically just upscaling what the original sprite. So if I didn't understand what I was looking at in the original sprite, then it didn't turn out. Then I didn't churn out a more realized version of the sprite, and I thought of that when I was looking at the healthy salad, because in the healthy salad you can see that those are clearly horsetails in the set. Is that supposed to be like a matzo ball in the center? Yeah, because the healthy salad, I don't think I ever realized that those were supposed to be horsetails scattered about inside it, like mixed into it. And I definitely don't remember drawing those when I did the HD texture for it, but I'm pretty sure that was one of the ones that I had to do. So, like, yeah. Anyway, we have a train ticket. Let's go use our train ticket. Good lord.
Luxurious Poshley Heights passenger ticket to board.
Yes, I will. Every time that part of the song plays, I think it's gonna go into the freaking Super Paper Mario theme where it goes, da-ba-ba-ba-da-da! You know, that was so off key. Oh my god. Why is there an electric guitar in this song? Man, this is the weirdest soup. I made this soup this morning, and it's like... I cut a carrot on a bias into medallions. It's just carrot, spinach, chives... with beef broth, and I mixed in, like, yogurt and paprika. And that's like the dominant flavor. It tastes like chicken paprikash, but it's like carrots and spinach. It's weird.
The Excess Express. Now this is what I call traveling in style.
3 days to polish the heads will be over before we know it, dearie. Oh!
Hmm?
There's something on the floor. Trash, perhaps? When did that get there?
Hold that paper. Pick it up and hold that paper. Ah! Don't go to Poshley Heights. Get off the train now or a sticky, yummy doom awaits it. Oh!
What a strange threat. Do you think that Belden woman might be behind it? Well, at any rate, the fact that the note is here means the culprit is on the train. We must find this ne'er-do-well before they can hatch a plan.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
There's a star piece here. Oh, no, no, it's not. It's a dried shroom. Well, good lord. Bonk.
Is there a...
One of these cabins. Oh, I like how the... I like how the music is a little more diegetic, because it already had like an element of diegeticness in the original, because it already sounded like it was playing over an intercom speaker, but in this one it actually like gets louder or quieter like depending on where you are in the place. Dead.
Hey, hello there. You know, you're just gonna want to get in right on this train. And I finally got a ticket! Dreams do come true! Oh, yeah!
There's Toodles!
Well, hello there, you ducky debonair dish of a man, you. You're smashing, dear. What's this? Me, a witch? Well, people have certainly said that I'm possessed of an enchanting aura. But you're the first person to remark so boldly on my bewitching beauty, dear.
Honk. Owie. Owie! There are giant mounds of cosmetics inside. Hey, it's Ziptoad!
Hey, guy. Yeah, you know this, but I'm the absurdly famous movie star Ziptoad. I'm gonna shoot this little multi-billion corn art flick in Poshley Heights, yo. I tell you, being a celebrity is tough. Everywhere I go, girls mug me for my autograph. Eggs hosting.
Die.
That's dupless.
Hey, it's the cute waitress.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. This is the dining car where you eat and stuff. Some people take this train just so they can eat our yummily fabulous food. And this trip we have a super famous actor on board, Ziptoad. Oh my gosh. Oh, I'm totally swooning. I so hope he comes here to eat soon. I want an autograph.
Die. I missed.
Oh no, she's sad!
It's Chef Shimmy! Hello! I am Chef Shimmy, the culinary expert, down to make our acquaintance. Acquaintance. So sorry. Cheep cheep is my first language, you know. Today's lunch is so amazing it will make her tongue crowd in shame. Please forgive so that my passion does not wither alone in a pot of loneliness. Die. Ow, God! I think there's totally a star piece. No? Okay. Can I already see the star piece completion in this area? 20%. Shine sprites 50%. Six is Pennington. So, is it your place that has a star piece in it? No? Hello? I am on my way back home. I have strayed so long, I have forgotten what it looks like. Oh, alright, I gave him like a Sean Connery voice, didn't I? I think I did in the LP. Hey, it's you!
Me? I have a very important deal to attend to once we arrive in Poshley Heights. I'm traveling on business, so everything goes on the expense account. Yes!
A
And here's the gold bobs.
Yeah, I'm Bob, and we're gonna get a birthday present. And it'll be cool! Aren't you jealous?
Die.
Owie!
We are en route to Posley Heights to buy a birthday present for little Bub here. My.
Die.
Owie!
Oh, you are the champion of the Glitch Pit, are you not? Yes, the great Gonzales. Bound for Posley Heights? Well, it's certainly a fitting place for a celebrity like you.
There was a star piece in the drawer. Hooray! Nothing else here. A couple of star pieces are things that you get from the actual, from the passengers over the course of the chapter. I remember.
Hello to you, and welcome to the Access Express. I'm the conductor of this train. And I trust you must be Mr. Mario from Cabin 5, makers of at home, sir. Just to let you know, beyond here is the baggage car. I'm sorry, but I can't let passengers in.
Oh!
What's that? Some sort of a sticky, yummy threat? I see. Good gracious me, thank you for letting me know. Please be careful out there and return to your cabin.
And now that that's happened, there'll be an altercation in the dining car. Well, not an altercation, but there'll be a confusion. Yes, here we are.
I thought I was gonna have a nice lunch on my expense account. Rats. This is truly unfortunate. Almost tragic, really.
Whatever.
I'm dying for a taco, guy. Couldn't you whip up some grub real quick? What? They took the whole pot? Really? The whole deal? This isn't in my contract.
Oh no, and Zip Toad is hearing everything! No! My life is totally ruined!
No! My heart cries out in the salty pain of misery! That was my master beast! I mean, my masterpiece! And art is gone and I am left with tears of horror in my eyes!
What's up, dude? Yes, I can say without the slightest hesitation that this smells like a case to me. But what shall we call it? That is the question before us, yes. What to call it? Yes, the case of the pot of supper stew that vanished suddenly and mysteriously. Indeed, that will do nicely. My dear train passengers, this is a full-fledged mystery, one that impacts you all.
What? A mystery?
A mystery, you just said? And, exactly what kind of dish is that?
Whatever. I am known as Pennington. You likely will not guess it, but I am a detective. At the risk of immodesty, you might say I have a certain nose for these things. And this little conundrum, my dear fellow passengers, poses no challenge to me.
Ooh.
The central clue of this case, and also the most vital one as it happens, is that our perpetrator took the whole pot, stew and all. And so, my esteemed friends, I can only conclude that the one responsible is you, you gluttonous woman!
What? What? Me? Are you totally cuckoo? I have, like, no idea what you're talking about.
Pardon me, sorry. Please accept my apologies, my dear woman. Oh, she's so sad. I felt I needed to practice my accusation skills, you understand? Yes, sorry. And then she just gets mad. And she's just silently mad for the rest of the conversation. Ahem, very good. Now let us get serious, shall we? This, I believe, will be a case worthy of my intellect. Yes.
Well, let me get this straight. So what we know so far is that we don't know who the culprit is. And, I guess that's about it, right?
Ah, this scene is for total squares! Forget you guys, I'm going back to my cabin!
You there, in a bit of a hurry to get back to your cabin, eh? You, sir, are highly suspicious. I have just broken this case. The true culprit, I believe, is Zip Toad, the actor.
Zip Toad? The Zip Toad? No way, Mr. Detective Person. You're just making stuff up. You Tweety Geezer.
Tweety Geezer? Geezer? I can't say I deserve such a verbal thrashing, but... Well then, who did do it, This puzzle deepens with every confounding step.
Man, your beak is so horizontal, man! A clue! There are traces of thing on the flooring.
Oh, hang on, this looks like a spilled stew on the floor. How marvelous, we can just follow the drops to the thief! It might even be the same person who wrote that sticky, yummy threat. What makes you say that? It takes a thief to find a thief, sweetie.
Sure.
Jump
Boom, boom, ba. Doom, boom, doom, boom, ba. Doom, boom, doom, boom, ba. La 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 la.
Is there some sort of hoopla going on outside? The stew pot, you say? Oh, stew? No, no, far too rich for me, my dear. And that's saying something.
I don't know, you look like you could have eaten the whole pot. Those hips had to come from somewhere, lady. I'm just saying. Don't shoot the messenger, alright? Hey, Hefty. I got you, you fart knocker!
Whoa, 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 whoa! What do you want?
Burp.
Sorry about that. Now, what were you just saying? Apart from the kitchen? Oh, I get it. Food gets stolen and you blame me right away with no evidence. Not nice. What? Narps are still on the floor outside. No, I wouldn't know anything about that. No, people spill stuff. And there's nothing in the drawer, so no need to look. You won't find a thing.
Die. There are several gourmet food magazines here. One of them is Initiative Devoted to the Food of the XX Express. There's a large photo of Chef Shimmy on the cover. His smile is just blinding. There's something under the magazines! Somehow, an entire galley pot hidden under the magazines!
I'm sorry! I ate it all! It was me!
So, you were so enamored of the stew that you wanted to steal it to devour more. And you stole the entire pot when the chef was chopping shallots. Answer!
Yes, yes, that's right. I'm so sorry, but it was a brief moment of weakness. It won't happen again.
Justice has been served. Very satisfying. May this terrible crime never recur. And you, my dear sir. Yes, you with the unkempt facial hair. My keen sleuthing instincts identified you as the correct person to collar the ruffian. Now, about that note in your cabin. Yes, I know of it. As the lone detective on this train, the conductor confided in me. But we cannot speak here. Find me in cabin 6 so that we may discuss this in private. Oh, and please return the pot to the chef if you could.
You're walking that way anyway! Well, I guess so am I, but...
So, dog. I have been waiting a whole 5 long time to meet, 5 whole minutes. I was rather impressed with your work on this last case, I must admit.
Oh, you know who this guy should have the same voice as? Is that fucking guy from Kids Next Door, the fucking, like, other guy who's, like, number 2's rival in his detective episodes, who talks kind of like this. Something, I don't even know.
I don't think the one you apprehended is a sticky, yummy malcontent. I've deduced this from the lack of any incriminating clues in his cabin. In any case, I must say, I believe you have a certain knack for detective work. So it is decided then. I shall take you on as my new assistant.
Oh?
To reiterate, my name is Pennington. I'm a detective from Poshley Heights. I am known in some circles as the penguin with the improbably large brain. I am sure you have heard of me, so that is all I will say on the subject. And as for your name...
Wait!
I demand that you do not tell me. I shall deduce your identity! That mustache. That nose.
Oh, all too easy. You, sir, are quite obviously the famed Luigi, are you not?
No need to introduce yourself. I know all about the famous Luigi. Now about this threat. Our man has declared his intent to yummify the train. A sticky, tasty explosion. That family of bob-ombs. They are definitely suspect. Now, Luigi, we will reduce this case to rudimentary facts and deduce the truth.
Okay. And the time of day changes. Hey, guys. D-
Oh, man.
Mom and Dad are fighting about what to get me for my birthday. I'm so bored. I wish I'd brought my GBA.
I think we should get Little Bub the Advanced Learner's Classic Series of Bubomery.
Two words, cheap and boring. Think more luxurious, dear. Perhaps a car or a house.
Bub is too small for such things, Gold Bob. Stop thinking of your own social status. He needs something that will further his education, not spoil him, honestly.
Pfft, I don't want any of that stuff we're talking about. Hey, mister, are you a detector that you could be a champion? Well, so think you can detect what I really want for my birthday? Sure, I'm a pro. Really? Cool. Okay, for me, what I really want, then I'll give you something in return. Here's a hint. It has an AU at the front. Now you've got it, don't ya?
An AU?
About loud and clear from out here. A train engineer. Oh, autograph. I was thinking like train authenticator. Like, what the hell are you talking about? I was like, engineer doesn't start with AU, but he wants an autograph. Open the door with those skinny ass arms. Hello. Thank you. Why can't I throw the boomerang? Thank you. Oh, you know what? Hang on. Had to publish today's episode of today's episode. Had to publish that chapter 2 video. That number 2 guy. Hey, lady, you gonna eat the pole pot of stew again?
You solved this incident in record time. I was way impressed. Hey, come to think of it, I could use your skills. Could you help me? Really? Wow. Okay, so I lost these shell earrings that my ex-boyfriend gave me, and they're like all full of memories and stuff. I really need them back. Can we look for them or something? Please.
Okay. I want to tattle these guys. Tattle this fool. Some people find her a bit spacey. Think she's an okay waitress? Any ideas why, Mario? Hey, Toodles.
Well, hello there, you fine specimen of a man, you. You're marvelous, dear. You solved rather tough mystery, didn't you? Yes, very well done. You're so ruggedly smart. Perhaps you could help me with something as well. Oh, how absolutely lovely. Now listen well. I'm looking for a gold ring that I lost somewhere on this very train. Could you please hasten the search along for me, you boldly brilliant man, you?
You know what? You know who this girl's... You know who Toodles' like voice grunts remind me of? Is Matara from V Shoujo. Like, the kind of like the cadence. I feel like she could be... Like, she could voice a great Toodles.
Gosh, that woman is so fashionable, it makes me sick!
Classy all the way. Yeah, if Matara could just put on like a sensual kind of fashionable, like beautiful, kind of like not that her voice isn't beautiful, but she, you know, she's a VTuber, she talks casually a lot of the time. Like, I think she could do a fantastic Toodles.
Well, shucks.
Dude, I wanna. Oh, for God's sake, I have to go talk to him first. Oh, no, you know what? I think I need to talk to Pennington. Man, oh my god. Fucking yogurt, paprika, cumin, like salt and MSG is all you need. Oh, right. Okay, I'm gonna try talking to you again. I don't remember exactly how to do this. Hey. Oh. Now I got it.
right, that's the Ratatouille, yeah.
The thing that young Master Pop wants most, well, let us deduce, shall we? Why, it is rudimentary! He wants a Game Boy Advance, my dear Luigi! Yes, I'm quite sure, my grasp of the modern youth culture's enthusiast desires has never been stronger.
He was a calligraphy enthusiast with a slight overbite and hair the color of strained peaches. Wait, who do you have to talk to get the... The stew was the most expensive thing on the dinner menu? The stew! The stew! Okay, I guess I'll just ask him for another hint. Okay, I'm not sure why they didn't just... If I walk all the way up there and he still won't give me an autograph, I'm gonna try on an array of clothes. I will become Mike Tyson's agent. Oh, I gotta talk to you too. Did I return the galley pot to you? My pot! Ah, yummy! Fresh meat! I like how the pot is gold in this one. It wasn't gold in the original. Please fake it. Butcher this language, though. So shameful. Please take it, I mean. Yay. Were there two tables there in the original? I thought there were three. Please give me your autograph. Don't make me run all the way to the end of the train again. Thank you. So happy. How happy can you get?
Gosh, I've never given out an autograph before. That felt fantastic.
So happy. Man, it's weird how much smaller his hat is than his head would be, than his, like, mushroom cap would be. It's like, does that hat compress his mushroom cap down? Weird, man. They do a walk down in the melody there instead of like a dip and then like resurface, you know what I mean? They go dum dum bum bum instead of dum dum bum bum, you know. It's weird. Is this when you get the other shine sprite? I think it is actually. He gives you the other one. Here you go. Man, remember in Paper Mario 1 when I went to the trouble of learning how to hack the game, like using Game Genie codes to dupe Merlovely's autograph so that I wouldn't have to give the only one to Koopa Coot?
Nice.
Now it's nighttime. Oh, weird. Is this song not diegetic in this version? It doesn't sound like it's coming out of a speaker. Let me go into a room and see. One blanket short when I was running out of passengers. I have exact blanket counts. I have exact blanket counts. Like, that's what you have exact counts of? Blankets? That's like the one thing? Like, what are you talking about? I have exact blanket counts. Like, is this guy blankets, like, obsessed with blankets? Oh, I think I do sense a little bit of compression in the music here. It's hard to tell. Because there's so much train noise. I honestly can't tell. Because in the original, the Dusk music was the only one that didn't sound like it was playing through, like, the speakers on the train. But I honestly can't tell if this one is meant to be the same way or not.
Holy shit, a ghost!
So you found me. Well, as you see, I'm a ghost. I'm cursed to haunt this place. A blanket? Well, yes, the conductor did leave one here. He didn't realize that I'm a ghost. A yummy, sticky threat? No, I left no such thing. I can't even hold physical objects like pen and paper. What? You just want the blanket, then? Well, I'll tell you where it is if you do something for me. What do you say? All I need is... your life! No, just kidding. Actually, I passed away in this cabin many years ago. But I think my luggage is still in the baggage car here. Inside my bag is a diary that I kept since my earliest childhood days.
Okay. I'm not gonna read your diary, jeez.
A horrible fate awaits you!
Whatever, dude.
A ghost! Eek! And you won't give your leg unless you get the drive in the baggage car. I see. Well, go on in. You don't say no to ghosts. You don't say no to ghosts. You sure enough don't.
There's nothing in here other than the item, I think. The item. Oh, weird. It's in a chest in this one. That's weird. How would so sleep in here?
In this form, can you see me all the time?
Yes. So I'll know if you're reading my diary at night.
I should have done Terry's quote as Mario, like, in this form, can you see me all the time?
Did you find my diary? In that case, can you place it in that drawer?
Oh, okay. Sure. That's a weird looking blank. I like how they like shaded the pinched bit, like, but it's just a circle. That looks weird. Without this, he's freezing.
You are very wise not to read my diary, friend. Well, actually, maybe not.
Okay, bye, weirdo.
Now, we have a little more to do in the morning, too, before we get to Riverside Station, but this is the crux. Like, the majority of our stuff right now is already done, mostly.
Because the whole sticky yummy threat thing does resolve. Right, okay, tomorrow is when we have to deal with the Ratui shit. Ugh.
So pumped up!
Oh, he's so happy. A mushy. A mushy. Mushy! Mushy! Shut up! Oh my god, stop talking! Jeez.
All right, dearie, let's turn in, shall we?
Okay. Yes.
Let's go play the fat... the fast falling asleep music. Getting in bed quickly.
Okay. Now we just have to go talk to Ratui.
What the hell am I supposed to do with Artie in issue 5? Oh my god!
Did she now?
I need another peachy peach.
Oh no, he's not in here? Oh, he's in Pennington's room. Yeah.
Oh, gosh! Ah, my dear Luigi, your timing is impeccable. A new case has arisen. Now then, Mr. Businessman, please explain the facts to my assistant, Luigi.
Okay, here's the deal. When I woke up this morning, my briefcase was gone. It contained all the contracts for our next deal and even our new product prototype. If I don't recover it, I'll lose my job at the least!
Now, calm yourself. The next part is vital, so tell Luigi very slowly.
Of course. Our company's new product is Nitro Honey Syrup.
I lost his voice.
Used properly, it's an amazing product that can even raise the dead. But if mixed with the calcium from a seashell and a bit of gold, well then the results are explosive! And the resulting goo blast would immobilize everyone here in a sticky yet yummy shellac! Falling into the wrong hands, well, I could lose more than my job!
Let's examine these facts, shall we? Someone has stolen your briefcase. No, you definitely had it yesterday. And the train has not stopped at all in the intervening time. I have it! Rudimentary, my dear Luigi, rudimentary! The thief is still on the train! Pennington, you've done it again. Anyway. Luigi, have you spoken to the waitress and the lady in cabin 2? They have both lost something on this train. The waitress lost shell earrings, and the lady, Toodles, lost a gold ring. Luigi, if the same person who stole those objects also has the nitro honey syrup, they could make this goo blast. They could carry out the threat and the note. So it is simple, Luigi. You must find that thief. You must apprehend the suspect before this dastardly plan is put into effect.
Uh-huh. I don't think we need to do anything other than just go right to cabin 1. And we need Vivian. Oh, do I need to wait? Please don't make me walk all the way back over there right now. I need to bring the fucking paper back to them first. Oh my god. We actually need that idiot to make a conclusion here? Really? Alright, moron, tell me something I don't already know.
Yes, I have, and I didn't come to the very obvious conclusion it would have led anybody to. What is this paper, What sort of clue is this supposed to be?
That's one of the contracts for my upcoming business deal!
What? I mean, yes, just as I suspected. Luigi, where did you find this very important clue? Cabin 1, you say? Yes, Ziptoad's room, a place I have long suspected. Come to think of it, I do not believe I've seen him today. Then perhaps he's hiding somewhere on the train, always one step ahead. Very well, my dear Luigi, find that Ziptoad. Oh, I think he's actually in our room, now that I think about it. I don't think he's in cabin 1. Die.
Could this be another clue?
This document is just like the other one. The suspect must be in here somewhere. It must be in here somewhere. There we go. That's the word. That's the line.
Oh!
So, where'd you go? Where'd you come from? You obeyed me that easily, guy! Huge!
That scene did not need its own music.
So this was our man all along, pretending to be Ziptoad, I see. All the while pilfering things from others to aid your evil plan. Yes, this was all just as I had deduced. I knew all along you were a fake. Yes, a discolored nostril hair tipped me off. And not only that, but I knew that you were the one who threatened Luigi.
Curses! I almost got away with it by getting off at Riverside Station, too.
Yes, you played a daring and ingenious little game, my false friend. But the jig is up now, fiend, and the good people in this train are now safe. For indubitably, no one escaped from this improbably large brain. Ahem, well, yes, in any case. At least return what you have stolen, Fink. Fink. Blah. Got the briefcase. The briefcase has honey syrup inside it. Ooh, that looks nice. Wow.
And there's the shell earrings. They remind her of her ex.
Oh, my precious briefcase! Is the nitro honey syrup safe?
There you go.
Do, 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 do. Oh, thank you, thank you. Thank the stars it's safe. Now I won't get the sack. Or dead.
Our rendezvous with disaster was diffused by my most rudimentary of deductions. Shut up.
Bing bong, bing bong.
Attention all passengers! This train will soon make a brief scheduled stop at Riverside Station.
Okay.
Oh boy. I wonder if this area has been expanded at all. Cause there was this is I don't know. I made it to floor 50 of the pit of, and Dark Atomic Boo wasn't there, so I'd be lying if I said I was expecting to see our pressure gauge friend here.
Hey, I think not, slick! You think you can hold me? No way! Bedlam Beldam would flip if I let that happen!
This whole Ziptoad thing was just a means to an end! It's me, suckers! Dupless! Beldam planned to goo if I Mario didn't exactly work, so I'll be cutting and running now. I'll leave the rest to Beldam! See you, suckers!
He just jumps away like a loser.
There's an exit we can use in the first car. Yes, 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 thank you. But first I need to drop off the earrings.
Welcome, welcome. Oh, did you find them? My shell earrings? I totally did.
Oh my god, she winks as she picks them up.
Ooh, there they are. There are my earrings. Thank you so much. Hey, and before I forget, take this as my thanks.
Winky face. Nice. Good lord. Yeah, sure you did. Alright, and toodles.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shoot. Okay, I might have to stop here at Riverside Station, because someone just messaged me. They're ready to play Terraria today. Here you go. You glorious creature. Oh, wait, that's not another star piece? Hang on. Oh, I already have all of them. Okay, never mind. Jeez. All right, here we are. Poop Pop Pete! Nothing over here? Okay. Where does one buy a train? Hey, the Battle Master's here. What the hell are you doing here, dude?
What do we do? Someone looked at the drawbridge and ran into the station like this. Oh, no. Shit.
Oh, huh. They actually let Hefty leave. In the original, he was too fat to leave. But I guess they retconned that because of body positivity or something. Well, that doesn't really make any sense. Our suspect was not only a fake zip toad. He was some monstrous being in a white sheet, which was exactly as I suspected. Too bad he gave us a slip like that, though. He was rather a slippery sort. We could have questioned him about all that Beldum business. Alright, I'm gonna do Riverside Station later. Speed! Aww.